Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernardo from the BTN HD, and yes, I'm super excited about this video. As you know, Apple released a new operating system, the Mac OS 11, and I needed to get into the lab and create a virtual machine because I don't want to use my physical Mac laptops or my iMac because I use it for my day-to-day workflow to edit and do all that stuff. So I needed to find a way to actually install this operating system into a virtual environment to do some testing. So I'm gonna show you guys how I did it. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to grab that installation file. So I am part of the Appleseed program. So I needed to download the Mac OS customer beta access utility. I clicked on it, I clicked on allow, it downloaded, bam, I double clicked on the DMG, it started opening up, it launched up, I double click on the package file loaded up, I continued, click continue, I agreed, hit install, I entered my password, and then I clicked on install software. If you give it some time, your system preferences will open up and take you directly to your software update. Just be patient. Eventually, everything's going to change. On your left-hand side, you're going to see that your this Mac is enrolled in the Apple Customer Seed Program, and you're going to see 10.16, right? Click on upgrade now. It's gonna start downloading the upgrade. It's about 10 gigs in size, so it's pretty big. And once it's completed, you're going to get this. It's gonna launch up so you can start installing. So, follow the prompts, continue, agree. And then, okay, I'm gonna select my hard drive to install and upgrade my current operating system to Mac OS 11. So when I clicked on it, I got this error. The operation couldn't be completed, BI error, domain error 3. And I'm scratching my head like, what? A lot of people have been having issues with this. Most likely people that are trying to virtualize this Mac OS into Fusion or Parallels. And I was having the same issues with VMware Workstation. So I'm gonna show you guys how to get it working within VMware Workstation 15.5 because that is what I'm using. So first thing we need to do is completely shut down your virtual machine, then locate the VMX file of that virtual machine. So my VMX file is actually located within Documents, Virtual Machines, and the name of the virtual machine. And there goes the VMX. I actually right-click on the VMX file and I open it within Notepad. And I went all the way to the bottom. Now there's three attributes that you need to add. One, you need to add the smbios.reflect/host and assign it to true. You need to do hw.model and assign it to MacBook Pro 15,1. Now, you don't really need to assign MacBook Pro 15. You can actually assign it to a MacBook Pro 16,1. And the board ID is equal to Mac dash and a number. Now, I'm going to show you guys how I got the model and the board ID. I actually took one of my Mac laptops and I opened up the terminal and I ran the following command. That is how I got the model and as well as the board ID. So I actually used the board ID of a physical laptop, a physical Apple laptop. So that's the board ID that I use within that file. Once you make those changes, save the file, start up the virtual machine, cross your fingers, make sure it's loading up. And automatically I knew it worked. Why? Because the install option was enabled. It was highlighted. So that's a good thing. Awesome. So I clicked on install. I got this little prompt right here. Added my password. I clicked on add helper. It started doing its thing. And I got the nice little loading bar. 3 minutes remaining. It rebooted to this. This process kind of freaked me out because it was there for a good minute. And eventually this loaded up. I was like, yes. And then this popped up, yes. When I came back to the machine, it was right here. I needed to log in. So I entered my password and I logged in with no problem. I was super excited. And a couple of things that caught my eye was the dock looks like it's been changed. A couple of the icons at the upper right corner has changed. When you click on the Apple, the sub menu looks more round around the corners. So that I know automatically that told me, yes, it worked. So when I clicked on about this Mac, I got the nice hallelujah that it was on Mac OS version 11.0. Awesome. Super excited. And that's it. That is how I got the Mac OS version 11 or version 10.16, whichever one Apple decides to pick. And I'm super excited because I'm start testing this stuff out for you guys. And hopefully you guys enjoy this video. Make sure to hit that like button. Also, do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.